Okay, something completely different. It's about base. Base is also a LibreOffice application. And not every time that we hear about base. Okay, but myself first, just to know, I'm local, so I made my car this morning in 20 minutes time. And it was comfortable. I contributed to LibreOffice so far with library which is called Access to Base. The idea behind was that there are millions of Microsoft Access users. Every user had once to make something in VBA, Visual Basic for Applications, and if he wanted to migrate something to LibreOffice, he had to know and to like UNO, and that was a very high barrier. So I made once, and I proposed it to LibreOffice, which adopted it, to make a basic library which emulates the API that is available within Visual Basic for Applications for Microsoft Access application. Two or three years ago, I had to go on the Microsoft site with the presence of 1,000 MS Access database files. They all were built or formatted in Microsoft Access 97 internal format. And you know Microsoft, well, with MS Office 2013, could not even read them. So I had to do something as a consultant to find a solution, and I started scripting something that went inside the databases to produce, well, an idea of what there was inside. And I, last month, I was convinced that not the same situation, but the demand could exist to have some tool that could have a look inside LibreOffice base database files and know what there was inside to document them. What was the idea of the base? The idea of base documenter? No, the concept is the same as before, but it was completely written. My aim is to share the ideas here around that. It will be published as an extension on the extension site of LibreOffice and OpenOffice. It will require LibreOffice 6.0 because I put in the access to base library some hidden entries or functionalities that I needed for base document. Okay? It should also work on OpenOffice with the access to base 1.8.0 version, maybe also with older LibreOffice versions in the same situation, but this is not warranted. What does base documenter here? Well, it scans an existing base application. Everything it finds in that base application is stored in a repository. The items, of course, tables, queries, whatever, and certainly the relations between them. And this is essential because every documentation you make about such an application requires that you can identify impacts when changes occur. And finally, it produces a readable report. I have chosen here a certain format for that report, but as soon as there exists a repository, you can produce any report that you want, if you script something or you want to design something different. The idea here was to produce a report in HTML with all relations between objects identified as hyperlinks, so that you can jump from one page to the other just to know, well, I have a query is using a table. Well, what is the table about? So the process is quite easy. The user opens its database file, its .odb file, starts with a button or a menu item, starts the execution of a process. The ODB file must be opened without the maker activated. So the database is scanned, it is the first step, and everything is stored in the repository. It is in the second step that it will produce the report. You can chain them, of course, but it is a second step because you can choose, you can opt for making the report, for instance, for all available databases at once. So all the relations will be represented as hyperlinks. This is fundamental in the resentment here. But we will use the notation. A query uses a table, and a table is used by a query. It's of course symmetric. You must be able to identify from a table which are the queries that are using that table, and the reverse, you can jump from the query which are the tables used by the query. So that symmetry is important, and for impact changes you must be able to go, of course, in both sides, in both directions. So what are the relations that you can identify in such a base application? Well, there are many. Of course, you have parent-child relations that are obvious, but they are not the topic here. But you have a huge number of impacts. An essential point is that you can have anything impacted in procedures. If you write some basic procedure, the change is great that you can impact everything that you have in your context. Also, a procedure can be impacted because it calls another procedure. And also those impacts and respective impacts have to be identified. We have also all the list of the whole list of the objects that are managed by this piece of code. Dialogs, forms, consoles, which are parts of forms or consoles, grid consoles that you can have in forms, tables, queries, fields that can be part of tables or queries, and procedures. You have also toolbar consoles, and also subforms that are part of forms. The repository is very, very simple. Two tables. Table of databases, a table of objects. What is relevant here? Well, a number of properties or settings, etc., are just stored as a JSON string. Very easy, so you can always store, in fact, anything very easily in such a repository. So you have a number of fields that are just long varchar fields that where you store a JSON string in queries. And you have also the two uses and used by items, which is just a comma separated list of item indexes. So the scan has to go everywhere through the base application and produce that database. Okay? Then the database is read to build HTML that I want to show. The You will start from a table of content. I have here two databases stored in a repository. They are quite complex because you see there the number of items that you find in of each sort. And if I simply click to the list of 15 database tables here, jump to another page. That page has one table with the data that we are looking for. And it's stored in a template where you can put some tokens like you have there in the white box. You can have a table view of your local table of content, I mean the table of content of the database I'm looking at. And you can have a tree view, probably produced, but it's just an unordered list of items in HTML. And this makes that I can jump to any of them directly with a click. And here, a very easy list of tables, table name, then used by, because of course a table never uses something else, but is often used by a number of items. And for instance, here I have table article, which is used by a query called make table new article. Here you have data about queries. I have a list of queries. The make table new article is one of them. I have a number of columns here. I can, of course, go again to the column used by. I can know how query is used. It can be a procedure, it can be another query. There is also a SQL beautifier within which we can make find clickable items like here tables, which allow me to go back, for instance, to table article where I can find details about it, details being the list of items, the list of fields within the table. And also, just to give an idea of statistical data. It's of course optional, but you can, for instance, find how many of these fields are null, or what is the longest string stored in that field, or what is the oldest date or the newest date, if it's a date field. Okay, this is statistical data. You can find also a sample of the data. Just 50 records at maximum of data, just to have an idea of what is contained. Okay, so in the same way, you can have forms. So information about forms. What is specific for forms? You can also store screenshots of the forms within the table. In the details column here, we have also the list of consoles that you find in the form. If yes, here. Here you have a grid console which has sub-controls. for consoles and for phones, you have also the idea of console source, or source that is serves as a data source for the phone. Okay, this gives an idea. I just want to show also that you can identify by this tool a number of items that are missing, because they are used somewhere, but they are not found by the tool. And you have also a full index of all the items found. So there are here almost 500 names identified in the application as a whole. So I go back to my slides. Just to say that you can store, of course, the data, which is in fact identified here by this token here. You can put it in a template, which makes that you can configure or design your page in whichever mode that you want. You can also associate style sheets. Define your style sheets a number of styles to have a nice design. And in fact, you can, I didn't show it, so maybe reply. I want to show here that with styles, you can, for instance, make that your scripts are readable. It's about the same styles that are used in the basic IDE. So that's how I design the styles, but you can design them as you want. And also there, for instance, here you have a call to another procedure with an argument that is a form. This is the form. So you have here a list of style names that you can use in your template to make it more easy. You have also an API, in the sense that most of these functions will be executed from some button or menu item, but you can also make your own macro to make your own scenario based on this API. The most used will be just scan and dock this database. It's the most easy and does everything. You can choose to make your the HTML output either with user interface or not. Just you can, of course, choose is the default, but you can also make in your scenario that everything is made without a user interface. Now that's the bad news. The performance today for the databases that I showed here, of course, these databases are quite huge and important, and you have a huge number of items. This is the performance today on my own PC. It's not the slowest PC that you can find. It's relatively fast. So this is the bad news. The scan takes, for the first, you see 2 minutes, and then 1 minute 30 for generating the HTML page. Okay, so I have a number of ideas to optimize that. And of course, it's a work in progress. It's not yet published. I hope to make it better, maybe not for the first version. What I still have to do now is the UV interface for define the definition of settings is not yet made, because in the settings you can choose, do you want a table statistics or not? You can switch them off if you don't want them. So what is costly in performance is the table statistics. It depends on the size of the tables. It will not be compressed. And then the passes are quite slow because they're written a bit. SQL parser, SQL is short, and then the basic parts, which takes a lot of time. I have not yet developed the part for keys and tables, and I have to test the software on a number of ODBs that I can find everywhere on forums. And I have to test it on serious basic libraries, which 10,000-15,000 lines of code might persuade or access to basic itself. And in later versions, I could include reports, which are not included yet. I rewrite the parses in Python. Today, the only Python part in this piece of code is the I don't know anymore what I was saying. So the Python is for the ending of tracing. I would like to make it also in Firebird instead of SQLDB, because the repository is just a standard base file. But today Firebird lacks, for LibreOffice lacks a number of field types. I need a long varchar type, for instance. Does not exist yet. Probably planned for 6.1, but not yet.
It's a master.
Okay, thank you. My time is up.